సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోపప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, వెల్త్, హెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షం టు యూ అండ్ యువర్ ఎంటైర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ టు. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత చాప్టర్ నంబర్ 4 వర్స్ నంబర్ 25. శ్రీ భగవాన్ ఉవాచ దైవమేవాపరే యజ్ఞం యోగినః పర్యుపాసతే బ్రహ్మాజ్ఞావపరే యజ్ఞం యజ్ఞేనైవోపజుహ్వతి. ద ఫోర్త్ చాప్టర్ అప్ టు 24th వర్స్ ఇట్ స్పోక్ అబౌట్ బ్రహ్మ యజ్ఞ. ద ఫైనల్ సూత్ర విచ్ బి సా బ్రహ్మార్పణం బ్రహ్మహవిః బ్రహ్మాగ్నౌ బ్రహ్మణాహుతం బ్రహ్మైవ తేన గంతవ్యం బ్రహ్మకర్మ సమాధినా. దాట్ వాస్ ద మోటో. So from the words first to 24 is the complete fourth chapter packed for Brahma Yajna. The third chapter, it spoke about that Daiva Yajna, complete in detail it described. Krishna began the third chapter as Loke Asmin Dvividha Nittha Pura Prokta Mayana Gha Jnana Yogena Sankhyanam Karma Yogena Yoginam. There are two lifestyles which are prescribed in this earth. There are two categories of people. All categories comes under these two categories. So they are called Yoginaha Jnaninaha. Yogis and Jnanis. Yogis means here it is Karma Yogi. Karma Yoga means that has to be done with Yajna Bhavana. That was described in the third chapter. Whole third chapter, it talked about what Yajna is and how can we convert normal karma into a kind of Yajna. And this fourth chapter, he made himself as the Homa Kunta, Havan Kunta. Now, in the fourth chapter, it's very unique. We spoke about, we discussed about karma and akarma. So every karma has got a fundamental base, substratum, that is nothing but akarma. So these two kinds of understanding methods are given here. Now he is going to list, there are 12 kinds of yajnas. Okay, so now yajna means offering. When you offer, it is converted into ash. A child is crying for ice cream. Okay, so when the child is crying for ice cream, his mind is endowed with the longing, craving for that material called ice cream. Now she is, you know, crying a lot, making effort and, you know, kicking the legs and pushing the hands. When parents, they deny, strongly they deny, she also increases that strongness. Finally, no other way, they provided ice cream to her. She became very calm, shant. She became very peaceful minded. What happens? So when you crave for something, after achieving, that craving, that mental, that emotions are becoming shant, peace. Now what happens? We have lots of desires. All desires must be done calm. It has to be what? It has to be upashamanam. Upashamana means what? We have to put it off. Put it off means what? We have to dissolve. Now that desire is dissolved in that particular material. When you crave for ice cream, the ice cream, when it is provided to you, you dissolve. Means that ice cream makes a shanti in you. It brings the peacefulness. That it all the layers, it becomes silent. It means we offer material for our desire. This is a mind tendency. Now, yajna means it is ulta, in opposite way. How? That's what the secret was unfolded in the third chapter. We offer material, okay? We offer material into the fire. We ask the fire to burn it. The nature of fire is to convert into ash. So when you burn it, you are offering in order to get new desired object. That's what yajna is. But you change the bhavana. When you change the bhavana, you are known as karma yogi. You are offering your desire only through material. You are offering desire. You are offering desire, not to desiring for new thing. Could you understand what I say? Now you see, if you have the ice cream desire, you replace that ice cream desire with that darshana, the Lord Krishna's desire. Now this ice cream desire is offered into Krishna's desire. Now when you replace, that is equal to offer. And these materials are used in the Daiva Yajna. Daiva Yajna means normal Vedic Yajna. People, they do for their desired object. But this person, he is very matured one. This person, he, though he is putting all the materials in the rituals, but he is offering the desire, not desiring for anything new. That's what the beauty of this Daiva Yajna. So Daiva Yajna is for karma yogi. They use Vedic ritual in order to become matured, in order to cross the papa and punya, to attain chitta shuddhi. Therefore Krishna said, loke asmin, asmin loke dvivida nirtha. Okay. One among them is called karma yogi. Karma yogi, they use Vedic ritual, is the first yajna is introduced. And these yajnas are having deities, so many deities are there. Ganapati is there, Lord Shiva, and Shakti, Parashakti, Chandi, and Varuna, Indra, so many yajnas are there. Vajapeya, Ashwamedha, Vishwajityaga, huge, huge yajnas are there. All of them are based on sacrifice. Now the next is Brahmagnau. Apare Brahmagnau Yajnam Yajneva Upajahvati. That's what we have seen as a Brahma Yajna, the verse number 24. He converts all the name and form and desire, that individuality, everything into Brahman. Everything he converts into Brahman. It means what? He offers the Veda Buddhi into Abheda Buddhi. All Dvaita Buddhi. Dvaita Buddhi means what? That duality. I am different from the world. Now, I am, my body is different from others' Sharira. So all the difference, one material is different than other material. I am defeated, I am succeeded, I am the winner, I am the loser, profit, loss, and happiness and sadness, the duality, I am different than the world. So he offers all those things in the name of the fire, which is in the name of Brahman. Brahman is the fire, that knowledge which is equal to the fire, because fire's tendency to purify, to clean it, to demolish all the difference. Like he has got the Agni, the fire which is known as Brahma Jnana. He offers in that fire all the Dvaita Buddhis. Because Dvaita Buddhi is not outside, you have to realize it. Know if you take a mango and apple, have a mango in one hand, apple in another hand. So do you say that there are two fruits I have, the two fruits, they are different species. I can, different varieties, the same species, because fruits are fruits. Now this mango is different than apple, apple is different than mango. But ask the mango and put it, that apple or mango nearby your ears. Will they say that I am different from apple? Apple will say that I am different from mango. Don't you know you cannot put together us? I don't like. They don't say. No object will say I am different than other object. No. Only human being and all other animals, even animals, they have their own instinct, nature to define. They don't define like us. The human being, we define as though they are different than us, and we also find the difference between two objects. We call it so intelligent, you know. Even, you know, apple, there are varieties of apple. Mangoes, there are varieties of mango, because our taste bud, it can have the different experience by each varieties of mango, isn't it? So that we call it, we are the supreme people, but we also create fear, anger, jealousy, and this egoistic nature by this difference. The difference makes problematic. The difference brings a sadness. Now, this Veda Buddhi, the Dvaita Buddhi is offered into Brahman. Mango is also nothing but Brahman. Apple is also nothing but Brahman. I'm also nothing but Brahman. This entire universe are nothing but Brahman. My success is nothing but Brahman. My failure is nothing but Brahman. Profit, loss, and happiness, sadness, everything is nothing but Brahman. This is known as a Brahma Yajnam. So that Agni is nothing but the knowledge of Brahman. He offers all this duality, that which only, which exists in the form of thought. Now he is sacrificing all the Dvaita Vritti into Akhandakara Brahma Vritti. Now he is doing Yajna. Every second he is on with that Yajna. This Yajna, he becomes like a machine, becomes like a bulldozer which smashes everything. When you do Namaskara to him, you will get Punya. You will get neutralized your Papa. You will be converting your Papa into Punya. So when you worship him, you will be nourished. That is the secret. This person, he becomes like a power tiller, or he becomes like a bulldozer. He becomes like a great sun. So when something goes near to the sun will burn. Like this person becomes completely like a fire. That's what Brahma Yajnam. It's a great boon in our Sanatana Dharma. People should know that. Then he becomes a free bird. Agni means this is not that is threatening Agni. It is Shanta Agni. Brahmani Upashantaha Nirindhana Ivanalaha. Viveka Chudamani describes that Agni is very silent, but it can burn Papa and Punya. It looks very cool and pleasant Agni, but it can burn Papa and Punya. It means your problems are burnt, all Dvaitas are burnt. These two varieties are introduced in this verse. Verse number 25, introduced two yajnas. One is known as Daiva Yajnam, another is known as Brahma Yajnam. Okay, see this Daiva Yajnam, which needs materials, which needs to have expenditures, but Brahma Yajnam doesn't need any expenditures. Just you are and your this vritti alone is enough. Okay. Let us read the next words. శ్రోత్రాదీనింద్రియాణ్యన్యే సంయమాగ్నిషు జుహ్వతీన్ శబ్దాదీన్ విషయానన్యే ఇంద్రియాగ్నిషు జుహ్వతీన్. నా హియర్ టూ మోర్ యజ్ఞాస్ ఆర్ ఇంట్రడ్యూస్డ్. దిస్ ఇస్ అకార్డింగ్ టు పతంజలి యోగ శాస్త్ర. This is yoga yajna. This yoga yajna is divided into twofold. We count as a two yajnas. The first one is indriya samyama yajnas. Shrotradini indriyani anye samyama agnishu juhvati. Juhvati means he offers. This is completely yoga sadhana. Yoga sadhana means there are eight limbs. అష్టాంగ యోగ, వి కాల్ ఇట్ యమ, నియమ, ఆసన, ప్రాణాయామ, ప్రత్యాహార, ధారణ, ధ్యాన, సమాధి. సో వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ దేర్, యూ హ్యావ్ ద పర్సనల్ డిసిప్లిన్. పర్సనల్ డిసిప్లిన్ వేర్ విత్ యువర్ ఇంద్రియాస్. ఇంద్రియాస్ మీన్స్ ఆల్ ఆర్ సెన్స్ ఆర్గన్స్. సెన్స్ ఆర్గన్స్ యు నో ఆల్వేస్ దే పుల్ టువర్డ్స్ అవుట్ సైడ్. దిస్ యోగి కీప్స్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ away from the world. Though these indriyas are connected with outside world, but from his own standpoint he restricts, he organizes well so that he could focus in one subject or object. That's what yogi nam yajnaha. So when yogi does this meditation called samyama. Now, what does it mean, samyama? It's very interesting, okay? So, when you study Patanjali Yoga Shastra, there are eight limbs, okay? So, these eight limbs, it prepares physically. When you bring the discipline physical level, it is known as yama. Yama means you should know how to sit, how to walk, how to stand, and how to eat, all physical disciplines. What to eat, what to not to eat, and when to eat, because when to sleep, how to sleep, and which the posture that you have to sit. So all these things are called yama. So you have to get up early in the morning, sitting for the meditation, sitting and going for the yoga. So all these disciplines are called yama. Niyama means this is a restriction of the mind, what to think, what to not think. And how to think, so how we have to think and how we can to work. So these, all these things have been called a niyama. And asana, of course, yogasana, we are very much aware about it. And another thing, this pranayama, so doing pranayama is, again it helps to concentrate, to become more focused minded. Pratyahara, not hanging on the worldly materials, just maintaining with minimum materials for our life, not longing for, making yourself relaxed and retreat from the worldly desire. Then comes dharana, dhyana, samadhi. This dharana means a completely focused, concentrated mind. That concentration effort is called dharana, because when you sit for the meditation, you can select any object. There are certain objects which are introduced by Veda alone. Veda says, Om is the alambana. Om iti brahma, Om iti idakum sarvam. It says, Om is the alambana. Om is nothing but Brahman. You can chant Om, Om, Om. There are rules and regulations for that. So sannyasis can have this omkara meditation. And the yogis, they also take, they prolong according to their pranayama practice. Usually om should not be lengthened more than 3 seconds. Om, om, om. But these yogic people can lengthen up to 7 seconds. There are rules and regulations. Then you can also get a lamp, earthenic lamp, not candlelight. earthenic lamp with ghee in it or with sesame oil in it, not with groundnut oil, but with ghee. You can have the small lamp in the dark room. You can try to focus your mind in one subject, in one place, or on some object. Even people select a lotus or rose like a flower. The first two are very much important. And I use the technique of bell. Bell means the temple bell. So that ringing bell can be also focused on. That is known as dharana. Now, when you make effort to be focused on the lamp or sound or the om, mind goes here and there. The tendency of mind is to not stand in one place. It goes here and there. In the sixth chapter, he says that wherever mind goes, you have to bring back. So he himself will teach what the meditation in the sixth chapter. Okay, that is completely purified karma. So the yogi, when he sits for dharana, he brings wherever mind goes, he brings the mind again to the object which is selected for the meditation. When he keeps doing that, then that mind has been trained to be in the place on the lamp or in the womb or with another material. Now, no effort to bring them from outside, it is stand and still with one object. It's known as dhyana. Okay, so this dhyana, then see, there are two: meditator and meditated and meditation. So meditator, one who tries to meditate, the object is called meditated, the lamp and the action is called meditation. These three becomes one, is known as samadhi. So there is only one, there is no duality, just advaita bhavana. That's what known as samadhi. All together, dharana, dhyanam, samadhi, if it is with one object, that process is known as samyama. Okay, that is the technical term from Patanjali Maharishi. And this samyama, you know, our rishis had used in different way. For example, if you want to have a very strong physique, like a rock, you can go and sit in front of the strong mountain, rocky mountain. You look at the mountain and you can start doing samyama. You just seeing the mountain, just mountain vritti. When you look the mountain, only mountain vritti. Mind may go here and there. Again, you are bringing back the mind to be endowed with the mountain alone, that rock alone. Then what? That's what known as dharana. Then afterwards, every day when you sit for that, the mind is absorbed by that rock mind, you know, that rockness. Now, your target is to observe the rockness, means that firmness which exists in the rock. That's what known as samadhi. When you become one with that power which makes rock is as a rock, you are connecting towards that power through the rock. That is the beauty of our meditation. In future, we will just, you know, if time provides, if Balaji provides the chance, I am ready to teach Patanjali Yoga Sutras, which are the boon for every individual. It's a practical meditation methodology. Nowhere it is discussed, because everybody say that, but they are not going and getting the core of the meditation. When you sit in front of the rock, you can get that firmness, the strongness, the power of the rock, and your physical system will become very strong. And you can also select a bird as an object for the meditation. You can do samyama on that bird, and not only that, on bird. So you are just particularly focusing on the flying capacity of the bird. You can just do samyama, you will gain the flying capacity. But it may take time, you need to have a proper guru, but it is said. And if you are not able to understand any concept, If you are not able to understand any secret, just you can sit and do samyama on that. You will be unfolded, you will be exploded the secret. If there is a maths is not solvable, just do on that samyama. Just, you know, you will be resolved. That's what are this the excellent person Ramanuja, he made all the maths theory. Samyama helped Aryabhatta to invent so many planets. They are still not named by our science. And this Varaha Mihira, who could have the astronomy, astrology, and Parashara, all our rishis, they did samyama on various aspects of the life so that we got the Shastra, which is born. That is what known as the glory of samyama. If you are born in India, you should be a rishi. Whether you attire in any dress, western or eastern, or whatever the dress you attire with, doesn't matter. But inside, you have to grow as a rishi who uses samyama. And some people, you know, they even do samyama on dharma, on the deity. When you do samyama on Venkatachalapati, you will get the complete blessings of him. That's what yogi, they use their indriyas, and respectively ear is connected with sound. They do samyama on the sound. They could hear without ear even. They could hear that, they could listen to the sound which is 1,000 kilometers far away. And they could also do samyama which happened in the past. If they want to know 10 days before what was the conversation happened in this place, if they do samyama on the sound, they will get back. They will come to know. But those people are not going to create problem, because their intention is to not create problem. They will do samyama on the sound, or they will do samyama on the ear itself. They will do samyama means they will focus on their hearing capacity. They will focus on the seeing capacity. They will focus on the taste bud, so that this hearing capacity, it won't go towards sound. That, you know, this is like a kurma. Kurma means a tortoise, which, you know, shrinks every organs when the problem is attacking. But this yogi, they make, you know, they shrink. They turn their attention towards the indriya. And they also do samyama on the mind. They also do samyama on the ahankara, buddhi, and its own swarupa. That is the method that is also considered as yajna alone. Therefore, it is known as yoga yajna, but specifically it is mentioned as indriya samyama yajna. They do samyama on their own indriyas. Indriyas means the 5 sensory organs and the mind and buddhi. They do samyama on that alone. Then the same, this yogic technique, one more variety, doing samyama on the vishayas outside, as I told, then it is known as vishaya grahana yajnam. That we will see in elaborate way in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.